Epinephrine, commonly known as adrenaline, is a chemical that narrows blood vessels and opens airways in the lungs. These effects can reverse severe low blood pressure. Adrenaline is a hormone that is secreted mainly by the medulla of the adrenal glands and functions primarily to increase cardiac output and to raise blood glucose levels. Epinephrine is normally released during acute stress, and its effects are known to prepare an individual for either fight or flight, which is why it's a primary medication for non-perfusing cardiac arrests. Epinephrine is used in cardiac arrest arrhythmias such as ventricular fibrillation and pulseless ventricular tachycardia, asystole, and pulseless electrical activity, known as PEA. It can also be used in symptomatic bradycardia. It would be administered after atropine as an alternative to infusing dopamine. Epi can also be administered to treat severe hypotension. It's been established that epinephrine can be administered when external pacing and atropine fail and when bradycardia causes hypotension. It is safe to be administered with phosphodiesterase enzyme inhibitors. Epi is also an effective treatment for anaphylaxis. It's recommended that it be combined with large volumes of fluid, corticosteroids, and antihistamines. Care should be given when administering epinephrine in cases where raising the blood pressure and increasing heart rates may cause myocardial ischemia, angina, and increased demand for myocardial oxygen. It should be noted that high doses do not improve neurological outcomes or survival rates and may actually contribute to post-resuscitation complications like myocardial dysfunction. We commonly see high-dose treatments with poison or drug-induced shock. Epinephrine is available in 1 to 10,000 or 1 to 1,000 concentrations. For cardiac arrest, epinephrine should be delivered IV or IO at 1 milligram, which is 10 mLs of 1 to 10,000 solution, administered every 3 to 5 minutes during the resuscitation. Follow each dose of epi with 20 milliliters of normal saline as a flush. Elevate the arm of delivery for 10 to 20 seconds after the dose is delivered. If epi delivery is administered via endotracheal tube, we're going to deliver 2 to 2.5 milligrams diluted in 10 mLs normal saline. Higher dose epi, which is up to 0.2 milligrams per kilogram, may be used for specific indications like beta blocker or calcium channel blocker overdose. If administering epinephrine as a continuous infusion, initial rate is usually 0.1 to 0.5 micrograms per kilogram per minute. Now, an example of this would be if you had a 90 kilogram patient, you would want to give them 9 to 45 micrograms per minute, titrated to a positive patient response. Now, for profound bradycardia or hypotension, we want to deliver 2 to 10 micrograms per minute, titrated to the patient response, delivering a drip via an IV infusion. We want to add 1 milligram of epinephrine, or 1 milliliter of 1 to 1,000 solution, to a 250 ml or 500 ml of normal saline. For treatment of anaphylactic shock, epinephrine 1 to 1,000 is given at 0.01 milligrams per kilogram via intramuscular delivery.